Hi everyone, my name is Pauline and I'm a Belgian nuclear medicine resident. In this video, I will explain you how people can die from dementia. Dementia is a very complex condition that is always fatal. In Belgium, dementia is the fourth leading cause of death in men after cardiovascular disease, lung cancer and stroke. In women, it is the first leading cause of death. If you look at the top 10 causes of death, you will notice that dementia is the only condition in the top 10 without a treatment to prevent, cure, or slow its progression. Dementia is often thought of as memory loss, but it's so much more. A diagnosis, most people are in either the early or mid stage of dementia, and they may be a bit forgetful, but they can still function in everyday life. As the disease progresses, symptoms become more pronounced. Eventually, dementia progresses to the point where individuals lose the ability to walk and speak. There is no longer control over bladder function, and many people have a hard time swallowing. This loss of control is directly related to the damage occurring in the brain. You can say that in the final stage, patients are unable to perform the tasks that keep their bodies alive and functioning. When someone with dementia dies, that typically is a result of another underlying condition or illness. A study in Germany analyzed more than 10,000 death certificates of people with dementia. They concluded that pneumonia is the most common cause of death. When the area of the brain that controls swallowing is affected, food and liquids can slip down the windpipe. When that happens, an infection can develop in the lungs, leading to aspiration pneumonia, which is sometimes fatal. This means that, in this case, the immediate cause of death is pneumonia because this is the event that caused the heart and lungs to stop, but the underlying actual cause of death is dementia because this is what causes the swallowing problems in the first place. Another common cause of death in patients with dementia is sepsis. Sepsis is a life-threatening condition where our immune system attacks our own organs. When patients with dementia have no longer control over their bladder function, they become extremely vulnerable to urinary tract infections. For most younger people, urinary tract infections aren't particularly problematic. But it can be extremely hard to detect a urinary tract infection in an adult with dementia, particularly if that person has lost the ability to communicate. Sometimes the infection spreads beyond the urinary system and causes a full body infection and sepsis. Sepsis can cause the organs of the body to shut down, leading to death. When a person dies, physicians have to fill out a death certificate. The problem is that a lot of people, even doctors, do not think of dementia as the cause of death, but rather think of whatever brought the doctor to the bedside, perhaps pneumonia or sepsis. They think of dementia as only being in the brain and don't think of it as affecting the rest of our body. American researchers analyzed the death certificates of 7,342 adults. They found out that 30.6% of the deaths were caused by dementia, and this was almost 3 times higher than the rate reported on death certificates. The bottom line is that national health statistics are based on a gross underrepresentation of the burden of dementia as a terminal illness. We're now in the fourth place, but maybe we should be in the third or second place. You might think, why is this so important? Understanding what people die of is essential for priority setting and resource allocation. In really short terms, the higher on the list, the more resources that you get to expand dementia prevention and care, but also more money for dementia research. Because while promising research is out there, funding is not. The most important take-home message is that you can die from dementia and that it is really important for national health statistics to write it down on a death certificate. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have a question about dementia that you would like me to answer in one of my next videos, please leave a comment below.